Tiger Stadium in Baton Rouge on a Saturday night. The thousands of fans roar as the Tigers take the field. The SEC on ESPN brings you undefeated LSU hosting the Eastern Michigan Eagles, with all eyes in the stadium and many around the nation focused on the Tigers' star running back, Leonard Fournette. And hello and welcome to ESPNU's College Football Primetime. I'm Alan Bestwick along with the coach Dan Hawkins. Tonight we get to see one of the very best in college football do his thing, the sophomore from New Orleans, Leonard Fournette, who's been spectacular.
Yeah, he really has, Alan. This guy's extremely special. He's getting some accolades like we haven't seen a young guy get in a while. Tremendous. He's gone over 200 yards a game in just three games, not counting the yardage he lost in penalties. You see right there, putting up some lofty numbers, breaking records here for the Tigers. A really, really special athlete.
The success that Fournette's had, both in his freshman year last year and so far this year, has a lot of people making comparisons between he and some of the all-time greats. What do you see in Fournette?
You hate to get started too soon on this guy too fast, but he really looks like a lot of great players we've seen. Earl Campbell, the power to be able to strike people and knock them off. Here's Marcus Dupree, the strength. Look at that stiff arm and let him get him off and running through people. And then you see he's also got the speed and athleticism of Bo Jackson. I know lofty expectations, but this guy is special.
He sure is. Bringing a lot of smiles to Les Miles in his 11th year here at LSU with a perfect 40-0 record in non-conference games with the Tigers. And you see 31-0 here at home. And Chris Creighton on the far sideline has turned around programs and won conference championships at three different levels of college football. He's in his second year at Eastern Michigan and looking to do the same for the Eagles. LSU won the toss. They have deferred, so they will kick, and Eastern Michigan will get the ball first. Trent Domang, the junior kicker for LSU, wearing what is the traditional purple jerseys for the night non-conference game here at Tiger Stadium. And back deep to receive for the Eagles is Amos Houston, 28. And Eddie Doherty, 87. The flashy freshman for Eastern Michigan. That'll be Doherty. Popped once, but he'll get the ball out to about the 22-yard line, which is where the Eagles will take over for their first offensive series. So Eastern Michigan, led by their second quarterback on the season, starter Reggie Bell, was injured in their opener against Old Dominion. So Brogan Roback is in, the redshirt sophomore, who threw for a career-high number of completions a week ago against Army. 27 times he threw the ball last week, completing just under 70% of his passes.
One of the tenets of the Eagles is unwavering in adversity, and they're going to get a share of that here tonight at Tiger Stadium.
Darius Jackson, who's been the load bearer with the ball for Eastern Michigan, is hit by Arden Key and Deion Jones. And a look at our impact players when Eastern Michigan has the ball, huh?
Well, where do you start? There's so many guys here on defense that LSU can really start with. Kendall Beckwith is the guy in the middle that makes it all happen. Darius Jackson, the running back for Easton, number six, 100 plus yards a game so far this season. He's really talented. Can he get enough cracks to get that here tonight?
Roll back to throw under pressure. Coming out of the backfield and off to the side is Cody Tuttle, the tight end. He's hit by Deion Jones. It'll set up third down for the Eagles.
Kevin Steele, defensive coordinator, starting off early, bringing Kevin Tolliver off the corner there with a cat corner blitz early on in the first drive, not holding anything back.
They need the 33. Ball at about the 28 and a half yard line.
Eastern Michigan, a no-huddle team, but you can see here, they just soon bleed this clock out a little bit, try to shorten up this game as much as possible.
Get the play call in with less than 10 seconds on the play clock. And have to call a timeout when they don't have enough time to get everybody situated in the formation. Not to mention the noise here.
It can get loud. They had plenty of time to get that call in there. Kalen DeBoer, offensive coordinator, I think he was trying to make a decision there and trying to bleed the clock down. Normally you want to get lined up at about 10 seconds. give you enough time to get organized and run a play.
So Eastern Michigan, 1-3 on the season, and a program that has had its difficulties for the last number of years. Their goals for tonight, fairly simple. They want to average 4 yards per called run. They don't want to give up any big returns on special teams and keep LSU to their season averages. And they want to attack the ball when they're on defense, particularly when number 7 for LSU has it tucked in his arm.
They need to get a lot of guys in the screen. They really do. They've got to get the all camera team going. They've got to get bodies inside the frame, because one or two guys is not enough to get number 7 down.
So third down and about 4.5.
Doing a little check with me, LSU showing man.
Roback moves, throws, knocked away on the far side. Dwayne Thomas with a nice defensive play for LSU, and it'll bring up fourth down and bring on the punting team.
LSU a largely a man coverage team. They're going to press man. It makes it hard to get off the line of scrimmage. Eastern Michigan got to get in and out of the cuts. And as you saw, only a 4-man rush, still getting pressure. That's going to be an issue for Eastern tonight.
There's Tre'Davious White, who has 2 returns for a touchdown already this season. Austin Barnes is first in the MAC conference in punting net, 13th in the nation overall. Angles out of bounds, and LSU will take over right around its 28-yard line for its first offensive possession of the game.
Punter Austin Barnes was excited. He got that one deep and out of bounds, and he was jumping up and down, and that's a good play, because you do not need Tre'Davious White getting this crowd going early.
So here he comes onto the field with the rest of the LSU offensive unit. Leonard Fournette, who rushed for 159 yards against Mississippi State, 228 against Auburn, 244 against Syracuse, and you see averaging 210 rushing yards per game, more than 91 FBS teams.
That right there, Allen, that's the I formation. Very seldom seen in college football today.
Brandon Harris throws, got a receiver wide open near side. Malachi Dupree is off by midfield before he's knocked down.
Cam Cameron starting the game with a little naked bootleg. Nice to get Brandon Harris going hot. Get Malachi Dupree involved as well. Really talented, the top receiver in the country a couple years ago. Need to get him going consistently. The passing game's been the one thing lagging for the Tigers this year.
Now number 7 touches for the first time. Fights his way for a couple of tough ones off left tackle. You know, LSU is last in the SEC in number of passing attempts per game. Well, when you got a guy like Fournette doing what he's doing with the ball in his arm, of course.
Yeah, you're going to play to the strength of your team, and obviously Leonard Fournette, and we'll get to this offensive line here in a minute. Coached by Jeff Grimes, these guys come off the ball. They're old school, road grader type offensive line.
Here he comes again, moving the pile, and has first down yardage before he's cracked hard. As coming across the formation was Nathan Adams, 36 for Eastern Michigan.
This is the staple power. Good patience, but just look at him bowl people over. Pushing the pile.
Up the gun again. And a few more for Fournette before he's stopped by Anthony Zappone, the middle linebacker for Eastern Michigan.
And this style of running, Allen, and this style of offensive play calling, it's one thing in the first quarter, but as the game goes along, that really wears on you, particularly when you've been seeing a lot of zone blocking, side-to-side things in practice and in other games.
Fournette again. Another first down. Mention the offensive line for the Tigers. Our impact players when LSU has the ball would be that Tiger offensive front.
Yeah, it was hard to pick one, but Hawkins, Tuoma, Posick, Clapp, and Alexander, Jeff Grimes has moved these guys around a little bit. Hawkins was a tackle before. Vidal was a guard before. And then, of course, Will Clapp's a freshman. And Tuama, the left guard, is a true freshman.
Harris throwing toward the end zone, tipped away at the last second. A nice reach inside by Daquan Pace for Eastern Michigan.
Good play by Daquan, but you also got to go up there. Darrell needs to go get that thing. Get it in his high point, get strong hands, get up there and go attack that. He's the deep threat on this team. They give him the fly sweep. And he's also the deep threat guy. He had a big deep ball last week against Syracuse, called back because of holding.
Gonna throw again. Comes out near side, into the hands of Trayvon Doral, fighting his way down inside the 10 and all the way down inside the 5.
Those short hitches are going to be there all day because Eastern Michigan has to play off. They have to give these receivers room because they got speed to get over the top. Good strong stiff arm. Nice job running aggressively after the catch.
So first and goal for the Tigers from the 3-yard line. The fullback, John David Moore, 44, in front of Leonard Fournette. Here he comes, into the end zone. Touchdown, LSU and Fournette.
Old school power play, you'll see this a bunch tonight. Pulling the backside guard, leading with Moore. After he got player of the week, a couple weeks ago, he gave, told coach, I need to stand up and say something. He gave his player of the week award to his fullback, J.D. Moore. Said, this is the guy making it all happen.
So Fournette into the end zone for another touchdown. And now Trent Domang on for the point after try, which is right down the middle. And a 7-0 lead for LSU. Another rushing touchdown for number 7. He leads the team in scoring. He's first in the SEC in points per game. He's got more tonight already. Probably not bad advice if you are an opponent of LSU, as Leonard Fournette carried the ball 5 times on an 8-play drive, including the 3-yard run into the end zone. And it's 7-0 Tigers as they kick for a second time in the game. Back to Eddie Doherty, who takes it at his 2. Doherty looking for a little running room, gets tripped up there and tackled nicely by Dante Jackson for the Tigers, and Eastern Michigan will get their second offensive possession started at around the 25-yard line.
Coverage units have not been one of the strong points for the Tigers thus far this year, something they're trying to work on as well.
Yeah, special teams. So, Hawk, you're Chris Creighton and you're Eastern Michigan and you're coming into LSU and you're big underdogs, but what you're looking for out of your team is to see how much you're gonna fight.
And that's really it, Alan. Let's face it. Huge underdog, hostile environment. Can you keep your composure? Know the snap count, do your assignment, execute it to the best of your ability.
Darius Jackson turns the corner, gets a few tough yards before he's knocked down there. Yeah, Creighton talked about how his team has made progress. He said it may be hard to see where wins and losses are concerned, but for example, look at their offense through 4 games last year compared to this.
Doing a nice job. Of course, they got a road win for the first time in forever in Wyoming earlier this year, and yep, not as many wins as what everybody wants. And you know, they're last in the FBS in rush defense, but they also had to play Army last week.
Darius Jackson again grinding off the side. He's a trap there by Devon Gottschall and brought down, and it'll bring up 3rd down and about 5 for the Eagles. Here's Chris Creighton. So I mentioned he's turned around programs at all different levels of college football. NAIA, Division III, FCS, and now taking on the job to try and do the same for the Eagles here in FBS football. Movement, players running each which way, and flags flying in from both sides of the line of scrimmage.
I'll start offense, number 75. 5-yard penalty, it remains 3rd down.
Tough with that noise. You think you hear a snap count or clap of the hands, and it's not. You're trying to communicate. with that offensive line up there, got a lot of noises running around in your head.
So you took two plays to grind out 5 yards. Now you just gave it back up on a false start. Now you face 3rd and 10. Rollback under pressure. Moves the pocket, throws downfield, had a man who tried to come back for the ball but was defended there, and it will fall incomplete and bring up 4th down.
Ricky Jefferson, the safety, getting over there covered on that play. Didn't have his head turned around. It's always a little dicey for the defensive back if you don't have his eyes back around. Makes it a little easy for that official to call PI if he makes contact early.
So the punter Austin Barnes on again, hit a 44-yarder last time. Tre'Davious White back for a 2nd time. Remember that Barnes angled it out of bounds and didn't have to face the dangerous returner for the Tigers.
I'm sure that's part of their strategy. That's smart.
Bouncing into traffic, that hit a Tiger.
I think it came off Duke Riley, number 40 for the Tigers.
And it will be covered and down there. And so LSU will take the ball at the 33-yard line. They're talking about it. Let's hang on here just a second. The officials are gathered and talking about what happened and where. And they'll signal it's LSU's ball. All right, so timeout with just a little less than half the first quarter played. LSU
football primetime is brought to you by Panera Bread, food as it should be, and Bass Pro Shops. Your adventure starts here.
Les Miles, Leonard Fournette on the Tiger Walk, coming into Tiger Stadium earlier today. 7-0 LSU over Eastern Michigan, and the Tigers come out for their 2nd offensive possession. There is Les Miles in his 11th year here, 106 wins versus 29 losses in his time here in Baton Rouge. Fournette, the deep back, as Brandon Harris under center gets the Tigers started. He'll throw. He'll throw downfield. Got a man running, Trayvon Doral, and flags will come in from 2 sides of the field.
Little bit of contact.
There is a Trayvon Doral, and our referee Ken Williamson will give us the word. But it looked like pace for Eastern Michigan.
Holding on the defense number 1, that penalty will be declined. Pass interference on the defense number 1, that penalty will be accepted. 15 yards from the previous spot, automatic 1st down.
You're going to see the bind right here. All these guys have to play the run. You've got to pick your poison, and then that doesn't leave you many defenders on top.
Play action, deep in the pocket.
That's where the speed's going to get after it.
There's the hold and the interference.
Good call. I'll let you get a little away with a little bit of that, but grabbing around the waist for too long.
So the ball just shy of midfield and a fresh set of downs. For Nick Brossette into the game near side. On the other side, Darius Geis has the ball, shifting, making moves into Eastern Michigan territory. Two of the freshman running backs that we were told we'd see a lot of tonight by offensive coordinator Cam Cameron.
They really love this kid. And as well they should. An angry, aggressive, violent runner that also has speed. 5'11", 222 pounds, just a freshman himself. They like to run that fly sweep with a number of players. A little bit of an issue blocking on the perimeter, but he ended up getting it sorted out.
So a 6-yard gain sets up 2nd and 4. Fournette back in the game behind Moore. And he'll have the ball. 1st down. Tracked down from behind and dropped by Clay Dawson for Eastern Michigan.
Running outside zone here with a lead, and he ends up cutting it back. And you see Clay Dawson get on the back, but he ends up going for another six after he goes for the ride. That's where Coach Creighton was talking about getting more guys in the screen. You need three, four, five guys on number seven.
Cam Cameron told us that the plan for Leonard Fournette tonight was the usual 20 to 25 touches. This is Harris to throw again downfield in the direction of Doral, and it'll go incomplete in the end zone. Again, Pace is there.
I think they got him for another pass interference down here around the goal line.
Oh yeah, yellow flag on top of the yellow U in the end zone.
Cam Cameron taking advantage of that eight-man front, little boot action. They've got to get this passing game going. When they start getting in the meat of their schedule, there'll be too many big bodies cramming that line of scrimmage. They've got to get those receivers cut loose.
Pass interference, defense number one. 15-yard penalty for the previous spot. Automatic first down.
See here, a little bootleg, throwing it back over the top on the post route. Cam Cameron spent some time, obviously, in the NFL. He's not going to let you load up the box and play man against these elite wide receivers. He's going to take some shots on you.
So Pace, the junior from Detroit, with that right arm wrapped around the waist of Trayvon Doral. Now the ball down to the 21-yard line. Here comes Fournette. No, they fake the Fournette. Throw to the far side in the direction of Tyron Johnson, and it goes through his hands incomplete. Johnson, another true freshman for this LSU team. And what we were told is, yards after catch, watch out. He's a burner.
Really electric player. Had a chance to go to practice the other day. They used him a bunch. I think they want to continue to develop him and get him in the rotation in a big way.
Quarterback keeper Harris around the far side. Everybody was watching. Seven and six goes into the end zone.
Cornerback Ray Tillman had his back to Harris. He wasn't sure whether the ball was handed in the zone or not. See right here, ball comes down inside. Ray's working against the stock block.
Good block on that left tackle by Gerald Hawkins, also the junior out there. Good left tackle. So Brandon Harris carries it in from 21 yards. And now the point after try by Trent Dolman is good. With the help of a couple of pass interference penalties, LSU down the field and into the end zone. On Eastern Michigan here at Tiger Stadium in Baton Rouge. A look at the play selection so far for both teams, and the Tigers are splitting it up. It's that old coaching saying, you got to take what the defense is giving you. Well, in this case, LSU's defense isn't giving Eastern Michigan anything.
No, they sure aren't. They managed to damage his jersey.
Yeah. And the ball blew off the tee, so Trent Domingue will have to set it up again. That last drive, four plays, 66 yards in a minute and a half, minute 36 to be specific for LSU, and the 21-yard run by Brandon Harris with his second, make that third rushing touchdown of the season, and of course the two 15-yard pass interference penalties helping things for LSU. Tiger Stadium, Baton Rouge, on a beautiful Saturday night, the number 9 team in the country. LSU Tigers taking on Eastern Michigan out of the MAC. Alan Bestwood, Coach Dan Hawkins here, watching Leonard Fournette and wondering what the numbers will be like at the end of tonight. That one will be downed in the end zone by Eddie Doherty, and they'll come out on the touchback for the Eagles. Tomorrow from 8 a.m. to noon, be a lot to talk about on College Football Sunday. We'll talk about the Heisman hopeful contenders. Of course, Mr. Fournette will figure into that. Plus some very intriguing games today. Alabama bombing Georgia, Ohio State in a tussle with Indiana, and more. It's Sunday from 8 a.m. to noon, College Football Sunday on ESPNU, and watch ESPN. So Eastern Michigan coming out on offense for a third attempt, and not had much success in their first two. Rogan Roback, the quarterback, now with Shaq Van, the other of the duo of regular running backs for the Eagles, next to him. Well, that throws far side, hit quickly on the out pattern was Sam Browning, the tight end, and he was steered to the side by Dwayne Thomas.
That's the issue with LSU. They're going to play man coverage. They're going to get up in your face. They're going to crowd you. Now, typically, you play this kind of team, you want to get the ball out of your hands quick. Well, hey, guess what? They're playing tight coverage, so it's not that easy. You see right here, Tolliver pressing up top, not giving any room into the boundary.
Throwback hands to Van. Not much going over the right side as that LSU defensive front continues to be very tough. Ricky Jefferson comes up and makes the stop there, and it'll set up third down and long.
Dropping Jefferson down out of that safety position. LSU loves to play man free, so you got man across the border and one guy deep in the middle of the field and everybody else locked up.
Back throws with players in his face and a nice grab with coverage all over his back. That's Eddie Daugherty, the freshman receiver from Mentor, Ohio for Eastern Michigan, who leads the team in receiving yards.
Excellent job by Roback. LSU bringing six, as you can see right here. He's got people's face backing up, little arm strength, able to fit that ball in.
So the first down of the game for Eastern Michigan, and it brings the ball out to the 36-yard line. Van will go to the far side and find some room and pick up a first down before he's tripped up and dropped by Lamar Lewis.
Lamar Lewis built a little bit like a strong safety, not the tallest guy, about 230, but he can run sideline to sideline. Eastern Michigan loves to run the fly sweep in the outside play, especially with Shaq Van.
So consecutive first down plays for Eastern Michigan, and the first offensive momentum and movement of any kind for them so far. And the handoff coming this way is Darius Jackson into the center of the pile, hit by Duke Riley, 40 for LSU. We'll pick up a couple, maybe three.
Number 40, Duke Riley. He's kind of the next guy in at every one of those linebacker spots. See Roback running zone read. Well, a little bit different issue because of Roback behind him is a true freshman. He can run a little bit. He's okay, but it's not really his forte, so you don't have that same effect in that zone read. It's pretty much a hand.
And offensive coordinator Kalen DeBoer is saying because it's that true freshman behind him in the depth chart and they want to redshirt him, they've got to be careful how many times they put the ball in the quarterback's hands. Coming near side with another nice game, and the ball in his hands was Darius Jackson. Jackson's an interesting guy because he only had 295 yards all of last season. He's already well over that, 418 starting the night tonight.
You see Eastern Michigan run a little zone action away, so the defensive end ends up squeezing it, unable to get back outside.
So third and very, very short. Like about 2 feet.
Probably quarterback sneak action right here. Oh,
timeout called far side. All that confusion trying to get lined up and what the play call was and all the noise causing Eastern Michigan to take a timeout.
Second charge, timeout at half. Eastern Michigan.
Chris Creighton and company will talk it over and try to keep this nice drive going. First drive of any consequence in this first quarter so far has a third and short. See, they've put together a nice 31-yard drive so far after going three and out on their first two offensive possessions.
Offensive coordinator Kalen DeBoer doing a nice job with those outside run plays with an influence block away. Saw two different ones, right and left.
Darius Jackson is the setback. Quarterback sneak. Rogan Roback. And it looks like he'll have the spot to move the chains and pick up another first down.
Always hate that when a shotgun quarterback walks up underneath the center. I mean, what do you kind of think is going to happen? Love to get somebody right over the center, get inside those A gaps, and at least make that quarterback have to bubble outside.
So across midfield into LSU territory at the 42-yard line are the Eagles. Play in the very difficult Western Division of the MAC. Roback with Shaq Van. And we quickly check in with Brendan Fitzgerald in the studio.
Thank you, Alan. We're going to check in Gainesville. Ole Miss taking on Florida, and it's the Gators out to a quick start. Will Greer, 2 yards to Jake McGee, and it is 13-0 Gators at the Swamp in the first quarter.
Ooh, one of many interesting games going on tonight in the SEC. Brendan will keep us updated on that throughout the night.
Crazy. That's one of the things that makes college football so awesome. There you saw Roback carry the ball on that play. That's not what they want to do a bunch of.
This time hands it off. Jackson trying to get out of the grasp of Devon Godshaw does. Keeps fighting his way forward. And a nice carry to first down yardage for Darius Jackson.
No, I had
Darius
four
Jackson.
Oreos and
really a strong
powder.
Runner, as we mentioned before.
And then I came
great
in the studio.
Drive. Little counter.
As I'm getting away from it.
Number of people having chances.
And I was just like, I need a drink.
You get out of Godshaw's clutches.
Like
that's pretty, you're a pretty strong runner.
So I got four more, and now I'm in here. Last week, though, I had
Jackson, the senior from Sparta, Illinois, has been the workhorse for Chris Creighton's team so far this year. So now down to the 32.5-yard line. And Jackson again cuts back. This time gets to the first down marker. They marked him a little bit short last time. So now they'll move the chains. And Jamal Adams and Deion Jones with the
stop.
Like
to see him stick his foot in the ground here earlier. You see, he starts to go kind of lateral, kind of need to know where you got to go for the first down. Now he gets it, but just barely. You almost have to find that first crease and cram it in there. Nice little drive for the Eagles.
Yeah, that was their fourth first down they've gotten on this one.
And doing it on the ground.
Inside a minute to go, first quarter.
LSU defense has not given up a touchdown in the first half yet this year.
Roback on the move is going to be caught and dragged down. Lewis Neal does the job for LSU.
Roback got to be able to get rid of the football here. Doesn't have a whole lot of time, just can't hang on to it. You literally have tigers roaming the jungle. Not going to be able to get away from that. Does a good job hanging on to it.
So the loss of 9 makes it second and very long.
Tough to overcome again, because really in a one back set as they're in here, Allen, you've got 6-man protection. It's hard to hang on to the ball with a quarterback that long to throw it very far down the field. You got to get it out of your hands quick.
Timeout whistled on the field.
I think that a little bit of a signaling issue. Seeing Roback talking to the coaches over there, I think there was a little bit of uncertainty about the signal. Compounded with all the noise in this stadium makes it pretty tough as well.
Believe there was a play clock issue there, so that was not a timeout taken by either team. And so they'll wind the clock and run it out, and the first quarter will expire on that. And this drive will continue in the second quarter. LSU remaining perfect in terms of not giving up touchdowns in the first quarter so far this season. So end of one. 14-0 LSU over Eastern Michigan. The Leonard Fournette wash tonight has found him into the end zone for the Tigers in one of their two touchdowns. Eastern Michigan. Michigan 14-0, though the Eagles on a very nice offensive drive that will continue as play resumes. Second and 19 after the big loss they suffered on first down. Rogan Roback throws into traffic, and it's intercepted. Jamal Adams comes up with the pick for the Tigers.
Jamal Adams loved to watch this guy play football. He can come downhill and smoke you, doing a nice job sitting over that. This is one of the few times LSU kind of dropped into a too high coverage. He didn't really see Jamal sitting there. This is one thing, again, the LSU defense has not done a great job creating a lot of turnovers this year. Big for them to get going. They also had a quarter of no penalties and a turnover. So very big for LSU in that category.
Jamal Adams got his first career interception against Auburn a few weeks ago. Just came up with his second against Eastern Michigan now. So Brandon Harris and the Tiger offense go to work. At the 28-yard line, Harris to throw. Heaves it downfield, looking for some leverage and some position. Malachi Dupree, but he was covered well there by DaQuan Pace, who has, it seems like, been the guy that's been in the focus of every one of LSU's throwing attempts. They've been in his direction.
Yeah, they're trying to get after him a little bit. Of course, he's been on the wide side of the field, and that's normally where you're working those types of shots. Little pump and go, quick screen and go on the outside to start that. As we mentioned, Eastern Michigan has to get up there and put extra bodies on the line of scrimmage to keep Leonard Fournette in check, and that allows for some shots to be taken.
Fournette has the ball. Tried to cut back after that hole closed up quickly and was turned away by Anthony Brown, 22 for Eastern Michigan.
You see what's kind of going here for Eastern Michigan. Look at all these guys crowded in the line of scrimmage trying to stop Leonard Fournette. You got man coverage. Pace is all out there by his lonesome. He just has to have no memory and let everything go. If they hit one on you, fine.
So third down and 9.
Now Eastern drops back a little bit and too deep.
Harris runs into trouble. Tried to come back out of this way and move the pocket. Clay Dawson, 15 for the Eagles, knocked him down. That was the first third down play that LSU has faced in this game.
Clay Dawson lines up at defensive end. He's not the biggest guy, but very active. Nice sack, getting up, rolling back underneath with Hawkins.
But one thing that Brandon Harris did there, that defensive coordinator Kevin Steele told, offensive coordinator Cam Cameron told us was important to them, he preserved the right to punt. He protected the ball. LSU still has not turned the ball over in 2015. So far, the only team in FBS football to not have any turnovers. Back that up 5.
Prior to the snap, false start. Offense, number 18. 5-yard penalty, remains fourth down.
That was the first penalty on the night for Les Miles and his team. They had 14 penalties last week at Syracuse. They have been getting averaging 86 yards per game in penalties this season. It was a huge point of emphasis for the Tiger coaching staff to their team this week.
You love to avoid as a coach those pre and post snap penalties you can control, and they really bother you.
So Jamie Keane boots this one away for the first time in the game. Ball dropped, but covered at the 42-yard line by Blake Banham. And Eastern Michigan will get it back just shy of midfield. And the LSU fans having a good time as their team leads Eastern Michigan by 2 touchdowns. If you have to go out and about somewhere during tonight's game, don't forget you can take it with you on the Watch ESPN app or on the go to watchespn.com. Make sure you download it. This and any of the ESPN college football games streaming live anywhere.
Have multiple devices because there's multiple games.
42-yard line is the starting field position for Eastern Michigan for this offensive possession as they try to put some points on the board. Remember, the interception ended the last one. Let's check in with Brendan.
Allen in College Station. Chance for Texas A&M to get its first win against a ranked opponent at home under Kevin Sumlin. Kyle Allen to Ricky Seals-Jones, and the Aggies have a 7-0 lead in the first quarter.
Brendan, one of many interesting games tonight. Got Ole Miss in Florida, with that Texas A&M game ongoing. And we'll keep you apprised of all of it as we go through the night here in Baton Rouge. Broken roll back to throw. Drops it outside. Red, well, that play was sniffed out by Tre'Davious White, 18 for LSU.
Tre'Davious White, he's a potential first-round draft choice type guy on this squad. You see why coaches raved about not only his ability, but the way he practices, his leadership. Everything he does back there is first rate. Of course, LSU is DBU, yeah, and he's adding to the fine tradition here for the Tigers.
So a third and long for Eastern Michigan. Roll back to throw. Dumps it off into the center of the field. Shaq Van doesn't get much. Chased down there by Kendall Beckwith for LSU, and it'll set up a punting situation for the Eagles.
Always tough. It seems like a safe call. But when you've got third and long, almost every defensive quarter, you see the defensive line putting the brakes on and redirecting. You're almost in the back of your mind kind of thinking, hey, this is a screen down right here. I think a lot of times second down's a better screen down for you. Maybe get a little more ferocious but pass rush.
So Austin Barnes back in to kick. The redshirt sophomore for Eastern Michigan, Tre'Davious White, drops back.
Drops way back. He's giving him a lot of room.
And flags come in. And I believe they're going to tag the center.
False start. Offense, number 43. 5-yard penalty. It remains fourth down.
Back him up 5 yards, and we'll try it again.
Penalty. Anthony Sabone, the starting middle linebacker playing on punt team, he was a little disappointed in himself for flinching.
So Barnes will stand at his 18-yard line. Tre'Davious White, I mentioned earlier, has two career punt returns for touchdown. One of them, a 69-yarder that kind of broke the game open last Saturday at Syracuse when the Orange were giving the Tigers a good fight. White will run away from that one, and it will be kicked away from him, and a flag comes in late. Flag thrown in from behind the play and landing at about the 35-yard line is the penalty marker, so we'll check that. You see they're going to mark the ball all the way up at about the 47.
Kind of an odd spot for a foul.
The referee is Ken Williamson.
They're going to go holding.
During the kick, block in the back, receiving team, number 87. 10-yard penalty for spot the foul. First down.
One thing to get back, kind of just being aggressive, he wasn't sure where the ball was going.
Kevin Spears flagged for that. LSU with the ball in a minute. Quarterback Brandon Harris has been the featured player in recent moments on offense for this LSU team. Harris has thrown the ball. He's run one into the end zone for a touchdown for 21 yards out. For a team that was last in the SEC in terms of number of passes attempted, it looks like part of the strategy for LSU tonight, the Hawk, is to get this guy going.
Yeah, and he needs to. In order for these guys to compete for an SEC championship, get in the playoff, and compete for yet another national championship, you got to hit some of these throws. And some of these receivers got to come up with these 50-50 balls, make a great play.
Leonard Fournette has touched the ball seven, now eight times in the game, and he's got some room here. Finally knocked down all the way out at the midfield stripe. The longest run of the night for Fournette.
Caught a middle crease. Coming backside. Little blitz. Kick out. Run in the alley. Great ball leverage. You see that ball high and tight. Talked about not turning the ball over this year. That's why.
23-yard gain on the last play. not much doing that time. Nice first pursuit there made by Clay Dawson, 15, and also Jake Kruger in the tackle for Eastern Michigan.
That play's kind of tough, Alan, because he's going side to side, which he's got some speed. But you love to get this guy with his foot in the ground and get north and south where he can cut and power cut and get vertical.
So a loss of a couple on the play. And Fournette again will grind out a couple across the middle. He was hit there in the backfield first and eventually stopped by Anthony Zappone.
We talked about in the break, Alan, would they come back out and run it even though the numbers disagreed with you a little bit because they've been taking some shots and throwing it down the field. Now this third down and, you know, a little over 10, to me this is a money down for this guy right here. Okay, if you're going to win in the SEC, you got to make a throw when everybody knows you're going to make a throw and come up with a big third and long throw right here on third and a little over 10.
Throw he will. Downfield into the hands of Colin Jeter and a first down for LSU.
There you go. There you go. That's a way to step up. Throw that seam ball. Excellent touch, good timing. Turn that thing over. Third and long, coming up with a big play. That's what you got to do in this league.
So the Tigers in business at the 24-yard line with a fresh set of downs. Harris will keep it. Will get tripped up just inside the 15-yard line. But a couple of times already tonight, very effective to pull the ball out from Fournette. While the defense chases seven, Harris is running with the ball.
One of the great things about this, Alan, is with his athletic ability, the threat is always there. Now, Cam Cameron's not going to wear him out because he doesn't want him to get hurt, but the threat being there is big.
Coming near side. Nothing doing there. Nicely pursued by the Eastern Michigan defense. And on the stop, Anthony Brown.
Came back with the same look. Really popular in football these days. You got to play. It looks good. Come back. Run the same thing again. I don't know necessarily whether the read was there for him. Darrell Williams checking into the game at tailback. One of the many, many talented backs the Tigers have.
One of five, maybe six we'll see in the game tonight. And Williams with the ball. Trying to grind for some room. He's hit there by Luke McClain for Eastern Michigan. And it'll bring up third down with the ball around the 10-yard line.
J.D. Moore doing a nice job getting up in there and leading the way. He's always got to be the cleanup back. You see him coming out of the game right now.
So Fournette back in. They could get a first down if they get the ball to the two.
This is all good work for Brandon Harris. Tight red area. Third and about seven.
Throws into the end zone. Looking, batted away from Malachi Dupree. And a nice defensive play by Juan Geraldo for Eastern Michigan will bring it to fourth down.
Like to see Malachi get his foot in the ground and get up and elevate and go get that thing. He's 6'3". You see right there, though, he's kind of falling away a little bit. Get over there and work out with that basketball team and get up and use your length in your hands and catch that thing at the high point.
We have
Laquan Treadwell a couple weeks ago, and we saw him doing that. You got height, you got to go up and get it.
Trent Domang on for the field goal try. 3-for-3 on the season. This one from 26. And is through. And add three more to Les Miles' total on the night. 17-0 LSU over Eastern Michigan. Trent Domang's field goal just into the Allstate field goal nets. Of course, Allstate continuing its program now of donating money to the scholarship funds of participating universities. For each field goal, an extra point kicked. Millions so far in monies donated by Allstate. Tiger Stadium, Baton Rouge, LSU, the number 9 team in the country, up 17-0 on Eastern Michigan after a 9-play, 66-yard drive capped off by the 26-yard field goal. A couple of key plays on that drive, a 28-yard and a 23-yard pass and run. The pass from Harris to Jeter, the run, of course, by Leonard Fournette, who's up to 60 yards on 10 carries in the game. Eddie Doherty at the four. With a seam. Fighting his way to the outside before he's finally tracked down from behind. That was excellent pursuit from the backside by 26. John Battle for LSU, who just refused to give up on it.
Been one of the weaknesses for the special teams this year with the Tigers. They've not been great in kick coverage, both in punt and kickoff return for kickoff. And so something you're going to have to work on. Again, they get in the meat of this SEC schedule. Guys will take that one to the house.
So, pretty good field position for Eastern Michigan at the 41-yard line for the beginning of this possession. The quarterback, Rogan Roback.
LSU all discombobulated with personnel. They're not really sure.
Roback hands off to Darius Jackson as we check on the scoreboard with Brendan.
Allen, twice this season, Tennessee has jumped out to a 14-0 lead, or a two-touchdown lead. They did it again, but this time it's Arkansas getting back into it. Brandon Allen finds Dominique Reed. He goes in. It's 14 apiece between the Razorbacks and Volunteers.
All right, Brendan, 17-0 here in Baton Rouge. LSU over Eastern Michigan. Short gain on first down. Brandon Roback has thrown the ball 8 times, 5 completions for 8 yards. 1 interception against no touchdowns. He'll keep it here. Race to the out-of-bounds marker. He'll get taken off the sideline by Dante Jackson, number 1 for LSU. But a nice game setting up a 3rd down and short.
Dante Jackson, you're not going to outrun that guy. 100-meter champ. Yeah. The state of Louisiana, true freshman. Coach is saying yesterday, Cam Cameron said he's the fastest guy he's seen since Darryl Green. That's pretty impressive credentials.
Yes, that Darryl Green, Washington Redskins Darryl Green. Third and short. Roback throws near side, grabbed and taken out of bounds by Cody Tuttle, the tight end for Eastern Michigan, and they'll move the chains.
Really nice little wrinkle. Boxes loaded up, little play action, get on the move. See, Dwayne Thomas gets kind of locked up inside. They're looking around going, who's got that guy? And typically they got to switch that off or lock it up, one or the other.
So the ball across midfield for the Eagles at the 48-yard line. Movement and contact there, a little jumpy, was Stevon Gonshaw. Put a hand on the Eastern Michigan center, Matt Thornton, and that'll bring a flag.
Flag in the play.
So the 5-yard offside call will make it 1st and 5 now. Remember, penalties, a point of emphasis tonight for Les Miles and his team. The 3rd flag on the night accepted against the Tigers.
Eastern Michigan's done a nice job so far. And they haven't had the big play, but they also haven't had the massive negative play. They've done some decent things against a really tough defense.
Here's Jackson. Tries to cut back, but was not fooling anyone, including Ricky Jefferson, who makes the grab. And it will set up 3rd down for Eastern Michigan. Don't forget Friday at 8 Eastern. The 2015 Geico High School Football Showcase continues here on ESPNU for the matchup between Bergen Catholic and DePaul Catholic. Exclusively on ESPNU and, of course, streaming live on Watch ESPN.
Ah, love me some Jersey high school ball. Used to recruit back there. Love those kids. Bunch of blue-collar guys. Play hard. That's good stuff.
Misspoke before. It's 2nd and short.
Corner blitz coming from up top. gets it out. Nice.
First down yardage there on the short drop-off pass to Sam Browning, the tight end. Whose only reception on the season before that one was a touchdown reception.
Kendall Beckwith playing inside linebacker for LSU, 6'2", 252. Really an active player, does a nice job in there.
Look at the time of possession there, Hawk. Eastern Michigan grinding out some long drives. LSU strikes for the most part have been quick. Throws, it's Browning all by himself inside the 10. He's caught and knocked down there at the 6-yard line by Jamal Adams, but a miscommunication somewhere in coverage.
LSU brought pressure. Rogan Roback doing a nice job hanging in there. The inevitable hit gets it off. Not sure. Looked like maybe Duke Riley, that was his guy. He, at least he was in chase.
So first and goal for the Eagles at the 6. Roback. Going to heave it out the back of the end zone with pressure coming and no receiver readily available.
Smart. Getting rid of it and throwing it out. This will be a landmark event,
yeah,
if the Eagles can get it in the end zone here, because it hasn't happened yet this year against this defense in the first half.
LSU outscoring its opponents 45-6 in first half play in 2015. Tiger fans trying to make it as tough on the Eagles as they can.
Shaq Van lining up outside. They use their right to run fly sweep action to him. They just bring a motion into the backfield.
He's going to come near side. Gets a block. Dives to the goal line. Touchdown, Eastern Michigan. Shaq Van, the redshirt freshman from South Bend, Indiana, carries it into the end zone. And the fans here down from Ypsilanti have something to smile about in Baton Rouge.
Eastern Michigan doing some cool stuff with some influence blocking. Guys blocking away and then running the ball outside. That's giving a little conflict of assignment there to LSU. Hat going one way, ball going the other. A little confusing.
Dylan Mulder does the place kicking for Eastern Michigan. He knocks it through and remains perfect on the year in point after tries. Well, a really nice drive downfield by Eastern Michigan. Capped by Shaq Van diving for the goal line. They put 7 up on the board.
Got one of the great backs in the country playing here tonight. I'm going to draw on this replay here we have from the end zone. The nice thing is, look at the conflict of assignment. It looks like the ball's coming inside and then the ball goes outside. Eastern Michigan doing a nice job getting out on the perimeter, running tough. But when you eliminate half the front back inside, tough to make a play.
The Shaq Van 6-yard touchdown run, capping an 8-play, 59-yard drive set up by that nice Eddie Daugherty kickoff return. And it's 17-7 now, LSU over Eastern Michigan, with just under 3 minutes to go in this first half. Brendan Radius will kick off. Dante Jackson and Darrell Williams back deep to receive for the Tigers.
Ooh, you do not knock number one with the ball.
He's got it. Cracked hard right at the 25-yard line. And that is where LSU will take offensive possession and see if they can march it down the field. 10-point game here at Tiger Stadium. Eastern Michigan getting on the board. Now LSU taking possession with a 17-7 lead. They'll start at their own 25-yard line. Leonard Fournette has touched the ball so far 10 times tonight. 60 yards of rushing all total.
Eastern Michigan's given up a couple of penalties that have hurt them. And there was one big long run by Fournette, but they've actually done a decent job really kind of keeping things in front of them and not having a bunch of massive explosion plays.
Defensive coordinator Brad McCaslin for Eastern Michigan talked about loading up the box. That's what they've done a lot when Seven's been in the game. So Brandon Harris will drop back and throw. He'll dump it off in the direction of Fournette, and it falls incomplete. Brandon, what's going on?
Hey, Alan, coming up at the half, Charles Arbuckle joins me. We talk about the beatdown that Bama put on Georgia between the hedges. Also, Ole Miss is gator bait right now in the swamp. We'll let you know what's happening there. And Ohio State just barely ekes out a win. Is it enough to keep them at number one? See you guys in a few minutes.
Yeah, there's an interesting follow-up discussion, huh?
It's hard. I know the guys in the truck wanted me to pick the four playoff. I've changed it about to eight times today. Every time you check a score, throw them out. Put them in.
Yeah. Harris to throw. Under pressure. Hit. Ball comes out right into the hands of Luke McClain. It's going to be all the way down to the two-yard line. Luke McClain, the redshirt sophomore from Grand Blanc, Michigan, comes up with a big turnover.
Clay
the first
Dawson
turnover
gets,
of the season. Sorry,
Clay Dawson. Clay Dawson gets in there and gets pressure. It's Captain Obvious, but you can't go through the SEC schedule. You know, see right there, coming off the edge, beating Hawkins. Clay Dawson, not the biggest guy. They got him listed at 226. I don't know that he's really quite that big.
Leonard Fournette with a touchdown saving tackle. The first turnover in 227 offensive plays for the Tigers. So now Eastern Michigan, they'll spot the ball at the three with a first and goal. Roback throws, swings it outside, caught by Cody Tuttle, hit just at the 1 yard line, and a touchdown saving hit on the sideline.
Yeah, that was a great play design. Exact same as they went on short yardage here before. Tuttle gets rerouted a little bit, and then Kendall Beckwith bringing the whole weight room with him.
Spot the ball at about the 1.5. Second and goal.
One of the things you work on as a defensive coordinator, sudden change defense.
Timeout, LSU. Sorry, Hawk. They just stepped out from the Tiger sideline and called time.
LSU, this will be a 30-second timeout.
All right, so while they talk it over, a minute to remind you about some women's volleyball action that will be familiar to some of those watching here in Baton Rouge. Wednesday at 7 on ESPNU. First, number 2 Texas takes on Baylor, then Tennessee and LSU at 9, exclusively on ESPNU, and of course streaming live on Watch ESPN. Well, when we had our meetings with the LSU coaches, one of the things that they talked about, Cam Cameron, the offensive coordinator in particular, was protecting the ball, something they've done well. When we asked what their goals were on the night for this LSU team, he said, continue to protect the ball. Well, their first turnover of the season has given the vast underdog visitors a little spark.
Obviously, the biggest issue is kind of pass protection breakdown.
So Brogan Roback.
LSU not sure a personnel matchup. You see the official step in there, holding it, saying, do you want a sub? Okay, good.
Brogan Roback, the quarterback. Darius Jackson, the setback. He's got the ball. He's into the end zone for a touchdown. The Eagles have another 6 on the board.
Go ahead, Coach Creighton. Coming into Tiger Stadium with E. Tough, unwavering in adversity. I'd say they're unwavering right now. Simple zone play. Get a little bit of push. Guys don't get off blocks. Lewis Neal. Boom! Gotcha.
So Darius Jackson into the end zone for his 8th rushing touchdown of the season. And now on for the point after try is Dylan Mulder. And it's a 3-point game. And that loud roar is suddenly a murmur here in Death Valley. Now this was supposed to be the one that the Tigers maybe rolled through kind of easily, because the road ahead is certainly a tough one. South Carolina, Florida, the non-conference game against the Hilltoppers, and then Alabama, Arkansas, Ole Miss, and A&M to finish the season. Really backloaded schedule, Hawk. Does that favor Les Miles in some way in getting his team ready?
Well, you'd like to think here in the middle that you'd be able to stay healthy, get better, improve your youth, and then get on your boxing gloves and finish up that last part. But again, that's college football. You need to get ready. You got to go. You got to play every week, regardless of who the other team is. And you snooze, and next thing you know, you're supposed to be beaten. You see the look of concern right here, glancing at, like, are we really just ahead by 3 points right now at home?
Les Miles said to us yesterday, he said, we do not take this opponent lightly. They have talented players. They come to play. Their offense moves the ball. But we're ready. Right now, Eastern Michigan putting up a much better fight than I think anyone anticipated through the first half of this one. Still 2 minutes to go. And a very dangerous kick return to Dante Jackson back deep to receive Brendan Ranius' kickoff. But still, a 17-14 game. Jackson at the one. Tries to cut back, pursued nicely and dragged down. They'll start at the 24-yard line with 2 minutes and 4 seconds to go in this first half. Talked about Les Miles not having lost a non-conference game in his tenure at LSU. The longest non-conference winning streak in FBS football is held by the Tigers. 50 straight non-conference wins. In a long, long time, 2002, since they lost a non-conference game. That was a game to Virginia Tech. So, 2:04 to go. Ball at the 24-yard line. Brandon Harris under center. Moore and Fournette, the running backs. Fournette's got some room. Caught up to and knocked down just shy of the 40-yard line, but a big chunk of yardage on first down for Fournette.
Coming right back downhill. They love this lead zone play. Moore cleans it up. Had a little bit of an edge up at the top of the screen. I thought that might check it and try to get to that short edge at the top, but staying with the inside run.
Here's seven again, but fighting through a block and not letting him get away. Luke McClain, the redshirt sophomore that just made that pickoff on the turnover a little while ago, and he fought off a block to hang on to number seven.
LSU has got the majority of their yards this year going to that left side.
Harris to throw. Looking deep downfield. Got a receiver. Ball a little underthrown. And a penalty flag will come out.
Ray Tillman didn't play the ball. Playing the man. 31 there. Great effort. John DeArce.
He had a step on him. Or two.
They got to work on this. Got to be able to hit some of these.
Pass interference. Defense, number 31. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
Great action up inside. You see Tillman running, but anytime you don't turn your head back and play the ball, it's going to make it easy on the officials. Again, though, some of these plays, I mean, DeArce does a great job, and I know it's tough, but you've got some of the best athletes in college football at wide receiver. These guys got to go up and make one of these terrific catches or one of these 50-50 catches.
So ball at the 44-yard line, a minute 14 left to go. LSU with two of its timeouts left, Fournette with the ball. Nice job fighting through to hang on by Jason Beck, 39, for Eastern Michigan.
I've been impressed with the tackling, Alan. I really have. There's been a lot of solo tackles or maybe one or two guys, which you certainly didn't expect. We showed the highlights there at the top of the show of Leonard just breaking tackles all over the place.
Under 50 seconds to go. Fournette again. He'll have a first down. He's dragged down from behind. And a nice play there by Clay Dawson, who chased him down.
Clay coming all the way from the top of your screen down inside. He's the unblocked player. That's why the naked bootleg back to that side has had some success.
To the 28-yard line. Down to 30 seconds to go in the half. Harris to throw. Looking far side, fighting for position. Dupree. I make that Trayvon Doral. And I'm not sure he knew where the ball was.
Love to see Harris get this thing up in the air and give Doral a chance to go get it. Hard to go high point it and go jump ball if it's out in front of you. You got one-on-one. No safety over the top. Give your big guy a chance to go make a play.
So back to the 28-yard line we go. Clock stopped at 24 seconds and a half. Harris will throw again. Outside, off the hands of Trayvon Dural. It'll set up third down and 10. 19 seconds to go.
A little bit of a comeback route, timing route. Harris took a shot a little bit in back of his drop, hanging in there, making the throw. Darrell Williams checking back in, sorry. And the youngster, Tyron Johnson, coming back in at receiver.
Harris just 4 of 12 throwing the ball tonight. And there are the numbers on third down conversion attempts for the Tigers. They need the 18-yard line, 19 seconds left. Pressure, throw, caught and dropped. In and out of the hands of Trayvon Dural, bringing up fourth down.
Simple pitch and catch.
But you got to catch before you run.
It's interesting. We've had a number of SEC games, Alan, and you kind of think about who's in the Final Four and who's going to go. And we watched Alabama. We've had Ole Miss. We've had Tennessee. We had A&M. That's a missing piece in this Tiger puzzle, is can they throw the ball well enough to make it down the stretch.
Longest field goal attempt of the season for Trent Domang. But he will easily punch that one through. And the Tigers will get 3 points on the board with 10 seconds left in this second quarter.
I love kickers. When they make it.
Yes.
It was awesome when they got down in the red area before. I mean, to me, anytime you get the ball at the 20-yard line, you got to knock it through, which he has. And then, of course, he gives you a little extra. Good job by Trent.
I should explain my laugh because Hawk, one of Hawk's things is how much as a coach you rely on the leg of one young man at times for your fate on any given Saturday.
Yeah, can be daunting at times. There's a lot of pressure on those guys. And yeah. Boy, those people that could step up and nail it. We were very fortunate. We had a bunch of really great kickers throughout my career. And gosh, they were just money. You got to get those points when you get in the red area. And hey, if you could get the extra long one right there, that's bonus.
So again, a season-long 45-yarder for Trent Domang. And LSU back up to a 6-point lead. Leonard Fournette there. Has touched the ball 14 times, 93 yards of rushing, one touchdown. For the man, a lot of folks thought, playing against the last place in rushing defense in FBS team tonight, would roll up some really big numbers. He's still got a full half of football to go yet. But certainly it's realistic to say a lot of folks thought he'd be just about done with his work by now, the way that this one shaped up statistically coming in.
Why you can't think like that? Everybody makes fun of Coach Holtz because he would always make everyone out to be world beaters, but they are.
Pooch kick, somebody better grab that, and finally they do, as that ball was bouncing free after it had crossed the 10-yard point. So 8 seconds left in this first half, and we'll see if the Eagles just come out and take a knee, or if they're going to take a shot.
Need to be careful. They've played well. They've got a couple of breaks. Obviously, the big turnover down there in the red area. Looks like they're going to kneel on it.
Yeah, not a bad half of play for Chris Creighton and his Eastern Michigan team. Picked up 7 points off of turnovers. LSU's first turnovers on the season. And they'll go to the half with a 20-14 scoreline. LSU leading Eastern Michigan. Check out what else is going on around college football today and tonight in the studio with Brendan Fitzgerald and Charles Arbuckle.
Thanks so much. So all of a sudden, a ball game in Baton Rouge, the late flurry by Eastern Michigan.
For the second half here in Baton Rouge, a 6-point scoreline between the number 9 LSU Tigers and the Eastern Michigan Eagles. Leonard Fournette on the field getting ready to try and lead his team to what hopefully for them turns out to be a little bit better second half than their first. Alan Bestwick, Coach Dan Hawkins a somewhat surprising scoreline to this point. What is Eastern Michigan doing that's keeping LSU off balance?
You got a couple things going, Alan. Number one, they're obviously crowding the box and outnumbering the Tigers at the point of attack. You're going to see here at first, it's not an 8-man front, it's a 9-man front. So Eastern Michigan crowding the line of scrimmage, playing man outside, doing a nice job keeping Leonard Fournette bottled up inside. Next play here is individual effort out on the edge. Clay Dawson doing a great job beating the down block by the tight end, getting out, making a play, rallying to the football. Now, here's the other side. Some of these balls, we got to make plays in the passing game, which they're not. Now, this was not a great ball. Some of the 50-50 balls did not have a chance to make a play. And then you see the drop right here. But four completions in the first half. Not going to play.
A look at our Taco Bell game track and where Leonard Fournette has been rushing in his attempts. You see very heavily up the middle and off the left side. But 93 yards. He's got a little more than half the touches they planned for him to have, and he's about halfway to what his average has been so far. But again, just a 6-point scoreline between Eastern Michigan and LSU. So LSU, after winning the toss to start the game, has...
Eastern Michigan's done a nice job in this first half. And Chris Creighton, head football coach, he talks about a lot of adversity, and they're dealing with it here today and handling it well. Kicked out of bounds. Best play you can get right there is touchback. You don't want Dante Jackson returning that ball against you.
So LSU will come out on offense for its first possession of this second half, and really, Hawk focus will be on quarterback Brandon Harris, not just Fournette.
Hey, four completions not going to get it done, Alan. Four completions, you can't do that. So part of that's on the receiver. We also saw some protection issues, and then there were some throw issues as well. So combination of all that, got to get that cleaned up.
There you see the numbers on first half play for Harris, with that one interception leading directly to 7 points for Eastern Michigan. So they go to work after the touchback at the 25-yard line. Fournette the deep back. John David Moore, the fullback. Here's Fournette looking for the edge. And he's got some room into the secondary. It's a foot race to the end zone. And Leonard Fournette adds another highlight reel run to his package for 2015.
Simple zone play. This is the first time tonight they've run it. You saw the strength and then the speed. Good feet.
And 75 yards for Fournette into the end zone. And now Trent Domang on for the point after try that he squeezes in through the uprights. Well, when you're in a tight game, your best players have to make some plays. And Leonard Fournette just did to open this second half.
I would have loved to have been a mouse on the floor in the locker room, because I'm saying Coach Miles, he's an old line coach and a running game guy. Yeah. I'll bet he had a few things to say right there to his troops. And Coach Grimes, the offensive line coach as well.
So in one play, Leonard Fournette finds himself up to 168 yards of rushing on the night and gives his team a much-needed boost to start this second half. And now the lead up to 27-14 for LSU.
Alan, I think one of the hallmarks of a championship team, you got to play up to your own standard every single week and every single play. And you shouldn't have to get shocked. You know, you shouldn't have to get upset. You got to come out and ball out regardless of who you're playing every week.
So while Fournette talks it over with the coaches up in the booth, out on the field, Eastern Michigan gets ready to receive Trent Domang's kick. Eddie Daugherty and Amos Houston back deep to receive. Daugherty's caught all of the LSU kicks so far. There is the flashy freshman. Remember, had a big return earlier that set up one of the Eagles' scoring drives. This will be a kick out of bounds. So Eastern Michigan will get a little penalty-aided field position to start the second half.
At the 35-yard line. First down.
I'm going to make a little wager with you, Mr. Beskwick.
What's that?
I'm saying that the Tigers are going to blitz a little bit here. They're going to heat them up and try to make some things happen.
Talking about Fournette and giving his team a boost when needed. He's done that a number of times this year with those big, explosive plays. Those 20 yards or more. Well, we can change that one because he just ran a 75-yarder back for a touchdown.
Hey, it's awesome when your back can take you that far, but you'd love to have some of those explosion plays coming from your passing game.
Brogan Roback throws to Cody Tuttle, who wrestles his way ahead across the 40-yard line. As now Eastern Michigan gets its chance to respond after turning LSU's first turnover of the season into 7 points in the first half and having a number of very nice offensive drives, some of which didn't result in any points.
Looked like the defensive line was getting off the ball just a little bit quicker on that first snap than they had in the first half.
Trying to say Kevin Steele might have lit a little fire under him back in that locker room?
I would think so.
Brogan Roback, the quarterback, 10 of 14, 53 yards passing in the first half. No touchdowns, one interception. He'll hand off here. And some tough running yards going up the middle from Darius Jackson. Knocked down by Devon Gottschall. And it'll set up third down. A penalty marker down on the far side of the field.
Offside, defense, number 49. A 5-yard penalty will result in a first down.
It's a freshman, Arden Key, right there. He can get off the ball fast enough. He doesn't need to jump too much. See Coach Ogeron giving him a little bit of business. Coach Miles snuggling up to him. I think he's telling him the same thing. You don't need to guess the snap count. You're fast enough to get off on the ball.
That is the fourth accepted penalty against the Tigers in this game. Remember, they had 14 against Syracuse a week ago.
Nice job in the first half. They got all those in the second quarter and right here.
Jackson into the secondary with first down yardage before Kendall Beckwith wraps him up and drops him.
Gap air up inside. Again, simple zone play here. Just a little bit. You see Kendall Beckwith not quite getting over the top. Number 52, the middle linebacker. They've got to fill in that gap.
Jackson's carried the ball 12 times for 43 yards and a touchdown.
I might lose that bet, Allen. I haven't seen a lot of pressure right now. They're playing base. I would have thought they might have pinned their ears back, try to get something happening.
Roback's going to keep. Scrambling to the outside. No gain there. He's chased out of bounds by Beckwith. It'll bring up second down and 10.
Kendall Beckwith, kind of All-American type expectations this year. Took over last year. He's the guy that kind of runs it in the middle for him.
It's on the watch list for the Bednarik and Butkus and Nagurski awards, all the big awards for the defensive linebackers. So second and long here for the Eagles.
Getting pretty noisy out there.
Jackson fights through one, gets away from Beckwith on the outside, finally going to be locked up and dragged down on the far side of the field by Ricky Jefferson, 29 for the Tigers. It'll set up third down, but a nice run there for Jackson.
Yeah, he's done a nice job tonight in the zone play. You can see he's got good girth to him. Guy's kind of packed up, comes in at 220 pounds.
So third down. 4 of 7 on third downs tonight for Eastern Michigan.
Got to think they're in four down territory right here. Simple zone play has worked well for them up to this point. And then if they get in fourth and short, they've been going with play action pass. It's been hot as well.
Roback throws near side, locked up, almost intercepted. Throw intended for Eddie Doherty, defended there by Dwayne Thomas for LSU, and it brings up fourth down.
A little bit of contact, but Dwayne getting his eyes around at the end of playing the ball, and the official going to give you a little bit of contact. As long as you're actually playing the football and seeing the ball in the air, you got a shot.
Now the ball at the 36-yard line. The place kicker, Dylan Mulder, his career long is 52. That was against Old Dominion on September 5th of this year. He's out to try it. This is going to be from 53.
LSU has a returner back.
Had the distance, but wide left. So the opening drive for Eastern Michigan in this third quarter comes up empty, and LSU will go back on offense. Will Leonard Fournette go back on the charge? The SEC on ESPN tonight from Tiger Stadium in Baton Rouge, where the number 9 team in the country, the LSU Tigers, lead the Eastern Michigan Eagles by a score of 27-14. And the Tigers going back on offense after the Eastern Michigan missed field goal. Their first play of this third quarter on offense was a Leonard Fournette 75-yard touchdown run. Fournette, the deep back, with the ball in his hands again, coming the same way. Gets shut off about 9 yards downfield by Daquan Pace. Looks like some of the fans were maybe rumbling for a hit out of bounds on Fournette, but I don't see a flag down.
Anthony Zappone over here running as hard as he can get. Little close.
Seven with the ball in his hands again. He's hit on the inside by Clay Dawson, who drags him down. And whereas in the first half, Hawk, it seemed like a lot of the plan was load the box, and maybe even on the LSU side of the ball, let's get Brandon Harris and these Tiger receivers going. Now the ball game is still in question, to use Les Miles' terms. And so they're handing the ball in a steady diet to number seven.
You have to show your heart, and you have to show your soul. And the heart and soul of LSU football offensively is I-backs and power running football.
Flag comes in.
False start. Offense, number 75. 5-yard penalty. It remains first down.
Referee Ken Williamson tonight. The flag going on the true freshman, Maya Tahuma. In at left guard. This LSU offensive line, an interesting mix. Got a couple of very experienced players and a couple of very young players wrapped around. So Leonard Fournette with the 75-yard run earlier in that last carry he had, closing in on his season's average. Nothing going on this one. Tosses the ball back to his quarterback, almost in a reverse mirror image of the play at Syracuse a week ago.
Said it worked for me, maybe it'll work for you. Eastern Michigan doing a nice job bringing pressure that time. So you see right here on the edge, does a nice job turning that thing back inside. Got to be careful with that. I know it worked. I know it worked for Syracuse, but that'll probably get you in trouble more times than not.
So Darrell Williams in, Fournette out of the game on this second down and 20. The penalty and then the loss on that last play.
Yeah, now just try to get half of it right here, Brandon.
Throws near side looking for Tyrone Johnson, and it falls incomplete, defended there by Ray Tillman.
Good back shoulder thought. Got to get it outside, though. Can't throw that ball inside. Harris throwing off his back foot just a hair. You know, second and 20. Just worry about getting half of it. Get yourself back in third and 10. You got a chance to go make it. But this is the kind of stuff down the stretch. If these guys going to win an SEC championship and get in the playoffs, you got to make some of those throws.
Five consecutive incompletions for Harris. And now the third down and a pile.
Now you got to be smart. Okay? Don't huck it into double coverage. Be smart. If you check it down, fine.
Pulls it down. There's a helmet off an LSU player. And the Eastern Michigan pursuit will keep up. There's at least one helmet, maybe two helmets off, and flags coming in from a couple of places. Gerald Hawkins, 65 for LSU, lost his helmet, kept playing. So that's going to be one problem for them.
Yeah, you're correct there. I think that'll be a flag there. You got to. Once your helmet comes off, you got to cease activity.
And Now the question is, were there offsetting fouls? Doesn't look like it.
Personal foul, offense number 65, participating without a helmet on. That penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Hawkins would have to leave the game from losing his hat.
See him staying with it.
Yep.
Once your helmet comes off, you sort of have to cease and desist.
So the excellent punter for LSU, who though has had his struggles a couple of times this year, Jamie Keane is on.
Tigers doing a great job recruiting out of Down Under, another Australian. And Brad Wing was here a couple years ago, now in the NFL.
Blake Banham lets that roll. It's going to roll out of bounds at the 12-yard line. And that's where Eastern Michigan will take possession of the ball in just a minute.
ESPNU College Football Primetime is brought to you by Oberto Beef Jerky. You get out what you put in. And Bass Pro Shops, your adventure starts here.
So we have in the picture on the left a tiger and on the right a hawk.
Coach having Hawks. A staring contest. That's Big Mike right there. That guy's impressive. Siberian Bengal Tiger mix. That was impressive.
I always find it fun how, you know, that's usually positioned somewhere near the visiting team's locker room or entrance onto the field. So Eastern Michigan with the ball deep in their own territory. The handoff on first down goes for a short yardage, about one. And it'll set up second down and long. 13-point game here. Third quarter. Brogan Roback and the Eastern Michigan Eagles gaining a little confidence after turning some LSU mistakes into points in this first half. Chris Creighton's team showing some spirit. If I were to say they were heavy underdogs coming into this tonight, I'd be understating it.
I'll be honest with you, Alan, that's a huge, and I watched film too. I guarantee you, after you watch that Army film, you're thinking, boy, this could be problems. Oh.
Beckwith across the line, free play. Roback throws toward the far sideline. It'll be incomplete, but they'll get 5 free yards out of this one.
Nice job using the snap count.
Offside, defense number 52. 5-yard penalty, repeat second down.
Now you mentioned that Army game a week ago. They gave up over 500 yards of offense to Army, 556.
Now granted, it was the option, and those option teams are always Navy, Army, Air Force, always up there leading the country in rushing. So, but yeah, to come down here in Death Valley, play like they have, real feather in the cap of Chris Creighton and the Eagles.
Second and short after the penalty. Roback. Look to throw, pulls it down. He'll slide with first down yardage. And they'll move the chains across the 25 to the 27.
Smart play. They've used this naked bootleg several times. Kalen DeBoer, offensive coordinator, do a good job mixing things up. And really smart play right there, getting down on the ground. Don't need your quarterback taking shots. As we mentioned before, you got a true freshman as his backup. So the last thing you want to do is get this quarterback hurt after Reggie Bell went down in the opener.
That against Old Dominion. You see the numbers on both quarterbacks tonight. So a fresh set of downs, and the ball's out. Roback is able to pounce on it. Looked like he and Shaq Van were in a tussle match over which way that option handoff was going to go.
That's the same play that they ran for the touchdown earlier. Faking the quarterback run in outside. Having problems now. LSU obviously made some corrections there. And you see Neal outside. He's seen that play a few times. He's not going to fall for it anymore.
So a loss of 7.
Be smart time. Look at that press coverage all the way across the top there. Right here. Bam, bam, bam. Guys up in the face of receivers. No free access. Looks like they're only going to rush 4. No, they're bringing the...
Not sure they got it off. Timeout called, it looks like, at the last second before the play clock ran out.
They got Arden Key coming off the edge, 49. He didn't really hear that whistle. Official needs to step in and protect the quarterback when that happens.
Charge timeout. Eastern Michigan. First of the half.
So running shy on play clock time, Chris Creighton signals the timeout, gets it, trailing by 13 here in Baton Rouge. LSU leading Eastern Michigan by that 27-14 scoreline. Whatever will they talk about tomorrow morning on College Football Sunday? Alabama's beat down, Ohio State's narrow escape. Maybe Florida pummeling Ole Miss tonight. 8 a.m. to noon on ESPNU. College Football Sunday. Exclusively, plus, of course, always on the Watch ESPN app.
4 hours won't be enough time. How about that TCU-Texas score?
Yeah. Woo! So second and long. Handoff into the center of the LSU line to Darius Jackson for a short game. Certainly a game effort tonight for the Eastern Michigan Eagles, who come in a program that has struggled desperately with one winning season going back to 1995, and they were 6-5 in that winning season. Chris Creighton, a turnaround artist, if you will, took struggling programs at three different levels, made him into a winner in his second year here with Eastern Michigan.
He talked about the E-tough of team first, obsessed with getting better, unwavering in adversity, and great effort and heart. He's got all that going here tonight.
Third and long, Brogan Roback feeling some heat. Down he goes. Lewis Neal with the sack.
He got the sack, and Devin Godshaw came up a little bit dinged. Just a ton of pressure. This group can really get off the ball and rush. We've seen a lot of dynamic defensive lines in the SEC this year that can get to the quarterback rushing four, and this is another one of them.
So Brendan Ranius. Check that, Austin Barnes, the punter, will come on. And Tre'Davious White, the dangerous returner, back deep for LSU. Barnes standing at his seven. Oof. White drops the ball, but picks it right back up. He'll be dropped at the 39-yard line, and that's where LSU will take over. Tigers leading by 13. Number 9 LSU leading Eastern Michigan. That punt just a minute ago almost blocked. Austin Barnes took a little while to get this one off.
Trey Quinn, wide receiver, see him coming right there. If he reaches out and touches that, just like he'd be catching a pass, he's going to block that. Trying to swat it like he's swatting flies. He's going to get there. He keeps coming.
And on the other end of it, Tre'Davious White dropped it in traffic, but it bounced right back up into his arms. And so LSU goes to work at its 39-yard line. Leonard Fournette, 176 yards rushing on 17 carries tonight, including a 75-yarder on the first offensive play of the third quarter. Here he comes. Not much running room on the inside. They've called Nathan Adams' number a lot tonight, 36 for Eastern Michigan.
It's kind of a double-edged sword, Alan. You know you got one of the best running backs in the country, and you can certainly run it against a lot of people. That's what's good for you. But if this passing game doesn't get going, they're going to struggle when they hit the meat of this SEC schedule.
And a very backloaded schedule for the Tigers in trying to win the SEC West and get into the SEC championship game. Here comes Fournette again. Pyle pushing forward, close to first down yardage. Look at seven, power his way across the yard to gain line.
That's LSU football. That's Les Miles football. Jeff Grimes, the old line coach, loving that. Might be time to play action and launch. They've not been able to hit one of those in the game yet today.
Fournette again with another carry. He'll rumble forward out to the 43-yard line before Clay Dawson drops him. Leonard Fournette has been averaging on this season 210.3 yards a game, leading the nation. There you see the numbers on him tonight so far. He's out for a blow. Darrell Williams is into the game, 34 for the Tigers.
They kind of let Leonard control a little bit of that. Talking to Coach Cam Cameron yesterday.
Running room up the center. Williams racing toward the goal line. Tripped up and run down from behind by Ray Tillman with a touchdown saving tackle.
They've had a lot of success pulling the backside guard, pitching this ball. There they're unbalanced and lead with an H and a guard and a fullback.
So first and goal. Here comes Williams again. Again off right tackle. He'll be inside the 5-yard line before he's knocked down.
Exact same play out of a little different formation. Old school power play, pulling the backside guard, leading with the fullback. They got the quarterback pitching the ball so he can seal the backside. Nobody can come off the edge and take it from the backside.
Cam Cameron was telling us about one of the true freshman fullback recruits they have. And he said, we like those guys. They're hard to find these days.
Yeah, one of the guys they've offered has got the last name of Miles.
Mm-hmm. Right now it's J.D. Moore in at fullback. Darrell Williams has the ball behind him, but will not find any running room. Clay Dawson again, 15 for Eastern Michigan, steps up and plugs a hole.
How about these kids playing their hearts out? Clay Dawson, like I said, he's listed at 226. I don't think he is quite that heavy.
So third down and goal, ball at the 5-yard line. One of five on third down today for the Tigers. Brandon Harris has a rushing touchdown in this one. Does not have one passing. Guns it in through the hands of Malachi Dupree, and it brings up fourth down. Hard throw, but in a tough spot.
Yeah, you got to spin back. Malachi just needs to get back there, and my ball might have got tipped just a hair.
So the field goal unit comes on for the Tigers. Trent Domingue will look to knock through his third of the night. The junior from Mandeville, Louisiana, has been perfect so far this season and this evening. And put another three on the board for LSU, and it's 30-14. Don't forget, as you're looking for college football and your busy life takes you out and about, you can always catch it live on the Watch ESPN app, wherever you are, and of course at watchespn.com. Make sure you download it. Stream every game live on Watch ESPN. And now we'll look at our championship drive update brought to you by Dr. Pepper. Hawk, we talked about the interesting day that it's been in college football, particularly in the SEC.
The old ball coach lost his quarterback earlier in the year. He's playing a freshman.
Ezekiel Elliott with his 7th rushing touchdown of 50 yards or more over the last two seasons. And Georgia just got beat down by Alabama. The longest run allowed by Georgia this season. Derrick Henry did it. They had a punt block that went for a touchdown. They just everything that could have gone wrong for the
Interception
Dogs.
Interception for a touchdown. Yeah. And, of course, when you got that Mack truck running you over.
Yeah. So here at Tiger Stadium, Baton Rouge, as we head toward the end of the third quarter, LSU expands its lead on Eastern Michigan 30-14. Someone watching from afar that might have been following other action might look at that scoreline and say they're not impressed with LSU playing a lower team from the MAC.
I think you do get a lot of eye candy, and you got to have some style points in some of this stuff, because people, obviously, you look at the Ohio State score, you think, it'll be interesting when the committee sits down and looks at the body of work. And who do they pull out of the hat? And it may not be all the names that everybody thinks right now.
Cameron Gamble, sophomore from Flower Mound, Texas, will do the kicking this time for LSU. Flag comes out. Not sure they got it off before the play clock hit zero.
5-yard penalty. Free kick.
Confirmed that he didn't get it off before the play clock hit zero.
That is a rare call, but that is a correct call, because the same thing happens when that official hands you the ball and you tee it up. It's the same as a normal play clock.
So that the sixth penalty against the Tigers on the night tonight. Check that. That is the seventh penalty.
Poor special teams coach. He never gets any pub until something goes wrong, and then they show him in anguish over there.
So they'll try it again from the 30. Daugherty with the ball. Trying to get outside. And he's knocked down at the 35-yard line, and that's where Eastern Michigan will take over. Eddie Daugherty, 87, true freshman, wide receiver. Been banged up a little bit, held out of some practice, had that yellow practice jersey on for no contact. But has not only played receiver, but taken the kickoffs all tonight for the Eagles. Don't forget the Geico High School Football Showcase is on ESPNU Friday at 8 Eastern Time. Bergen Catholic and DePaul Catholic. Streaming live, of course, on Watch ESPN also, in addition to here on ESPNU.
Bergen Catholic. That'd be my man, Nunzio. Nunzio Campanelli.
So, Brogan Rollback. The quarterback will throw. Back the other way to Cody Tuttle. He'll finally get knocked out of bounds as he got away from Tre'Davious White, but he was run down by Sione Tahuma, the defensive lineman who had nice pursuit going to the far sideline.
Really fun scheme, little motion, roll out to the right, throw it back screen left. Tre'Davious was the only guy there, did a nice job kind of slowing things up until pursuit got in.
So they move the chains and the ball out close to midfield at the 47. Rollback throws again, and again hits. This time Sam Browning comes across at that tight end, or Y back, as they call it, in their offensive scheme.
I've been impressed how Kalen DeBoer's handled this game, how Brogan Rollback has really got rid of football. He looks very much poised and calm. They've ran the ball well at times. You know, they're not beating themselves. They're not losing the game. Here they come in two tights. Haven't seen that much tonight from the Eagles.
Pressure. Rollback sees it, dumps the ball off. Far sideline with some running room is Browning. Cuts back inside. Check that. That's Shaq Van out of the backfield who has it. And he's all the way down at the 13-yard line.
Same scheme they had just a second ago. Just a little different look. Eastern Michigan trying to hurry up right here and catch him off balance. Little throwback screen. Really well set up.
Throw again out far side with the ball. Dustin Creel into the end zone for an Eastern Michigan touchdown. LSU player down on the far side of the field. And so Dustin Creel, the senior from Industry, Pennsylvania, takes the ball into the end zone, and there is the LSU player who's down and being attended to by the medical staff.
Well, he wanted great effort. He got that. He wanted heart. He got that. He wanted unwavering in adversity. He's getting that. Coach Creighton. Tip Dwayne, of the cap to the Eagles.
Dwayne Thomas, the injured player there, you see sitting up and being attended to. So, a very efficient march down the field by Eastern Michigan.
Couple of huge plays, then they go fast. Smoke screen outside. Got a chance to make a tackle right there. Tre'Davious White, and he tries to go for the strip.
And you saw Thomas there just kind of grabbing his back as he bounced off the ground and started to roll over. So Thomas comes off, and Eastern Michigan completes a four-play, 66-yard drive in a minute and 18 seconds. And that 33-yard play to Shaq Van, the pass and run, set up the score, and now the offense comes back onto the field, trailing by 10 for the two-point try to make it a one-score game. 0 for 1 in two-point attempts this season are the Eagles. Direct snap goes to Darius Jackson, hands back to Daugherty. He throws to the quarterback, rollback. Hello, two-point conversion.
That was awesome.
That was your,
they even thought it was awesome.
That was your kind of play. Razzle and dazzle.
Brogan walks off, direct snap, reverse throwback to the quarterback. Right here, Daugherty throws it.
That was the second passing attempt this season for Eddie Daugherty. He was 0 for 1 before that. Now he's 1 for 2 and put 2 on the board, and it's now a one-score game here in Baton Rouge.
People are migrating over. They're seeing that score. They're flicking it back over. They're going, what's going on in Death Valley?
Well, what's going on is that a team that was heavy underdogs, LSU was given a 99% chance of winning this game by FPI. A team that was heavy underdogs is playing their hearts out. And they're giving an effort. And LSU in some areas just, I mean, frankly, I think Wes Miles would agree with this, just hasn't looked as sharp as they should.
Well, on that drive there, they used their aggression against them because they flow to the right, throwback screen to the left, had it well set up, and then obviously the misdirection, the Houdini play there on the two-point play, tremendous. And when you play against athletic teams, that's what you have to do is keep them off balance.
Onside kick, but kicked it out of bounds on a big bounce. And the ball went out at the 48-yard line.
Boy, they had a shot. That ball had a little bit too much velocity. They had a shot.
Kick out of bounds, number 65. A 5-yard penalty will be enforced. We'll spot the ball. Went out of bounds. First down.
Love the call. Love the aggressive. Ball's only got to go 10 yards, so it's got to go right there. Watch the kick. He's just a little hot. You see LSU backing up. They got a chance. If they get the kick, they got it. It's a great call. Just a little better kick. Just a little bit too much smoke on that ball.
So it sets up the Tigers with excellent field position now at the 43-yard line. Fournette back in the game. With 190 yards rushing and adding to that total here. All the way down to the 25-yard line, Leonard Fournette. That will put him over 200 yards. 208 to be specific. Quick injury timeout, his opponent off the field. Yep. Yeah, sorry, Hawk.
He does so many phenomenal things right there, Allen. Just, you look from the end zone, copy the vision, going unbalanced here.
More tough yards, down to the 17.
Coach Miles not going to mess around right here. He's going right to the heart of LSU football. He'd like to throw it around and get his quarterback some work, but one score game. All right, we're going to load up number 7, and we're going to run this thing.
Just a one score game. As we get to the end of the third quarter, LSU leading by just 8. That's headline number 1. Headline 1A, Leonard Fournette, up over 200 yards rushing again tonight, including a 75-yard touchdown streak earlier. The SEC on ESPN goes to the fourth quarter at Tiger Stadium, Baton Rouge, with LSU leading Eastern Michigan by just one score, 30-22. LSU with the ball and driving. Alan Bestwick, Coach Dan Hawkins, and our ESPNU college football primetime team, Leonard Fournette, with the ball in his hands, trying to get the first down, bullying forward. It'll depend on the spot, but Fournette, I think it's fair to say, has pretty much been the offense for LSU tonight.
Tigers tried to go with a hurry up power play that they've been running pretty much at will tonight.
Fournette, 23 carries, 218 yards, two touchdowns. Two other players have had nine carries running. They've thrown the ball 15 times, only completed four. Eastern Michigan's loaded up the box. Number seven carries the ball again, gets down close to the 10-yard line. And a player down on the field for the Tigers, helmet off. That's Maya Tahuma, the big 327-pound left guard. Looks like he's stretching a cramp.
Got the true freshman getting a lot of snaps over there. They've been running primarily to the right side.
So injury timeout here in Baton Rouge with LSU driving. Back at Tiger Stadium, Maya Tahuma has walked off the field under his own power. LSU back over the ball, waiting for officials to signal play with a second and six. Trying to open up more than just the 8-point lead they currently hold over the Eastern Michigan Eagles. Leonard Fournette with his 23rd carry on the night and his third touchdown into the end zone for the Tigers.
Making a lot of money over here on the right-hand side as you look at. Simple lead zone. J.D. Moore doing work at the fullback position.
Leonard Fournette, second in the nation in points per game. First in the SEC, averaging 16 coming in. He's just scored his third touchdown on the night. Trent Domang's point after gives LSU a little breathing room on Eastern Michigan. As it's now a 15-point game here in the fourth quarter. Fournette, 11 yards into the end zone. He's up to 233 on the night. Still plenty of time to go in this fourth quarter. Now a two-score game after Leonard Fournette caps off a five-play, 43-yard drive after the failed onside kick attempt by Eastern Michigan. Fournette carrying the ball all five times and going into the end zone from 11 yards out. You see right now closing in on the all-time record for single-game rushing yardage. 250 is the number. And Fournette's at 233 with a lot of time to go in this fourth quarter. The kick taken by Eddie Doherty. Tries to spin away, but he'll be grabbed and knocked down at the 24-yard line. Well, I don't know how else you'd call an AT&T strong performance on the night, but number seven, Leonard Fournette, he's got to be the guy.
Really a pleasure to watch. Breaking some tackles. His O-line doing a nice job also. Doesn't turn the ball over. Got some speed. Pretty good vision, and he's got a little patience as well. Really fun to watch.
Touchdown runs of 3 yards, 75 yards, and now 11 yards on the night. That 75-yarder being the very beginning of the third quarter. So now Fournette and the offense on the bench, while the LSU defense tries to contain Eastern Michigan's offense, who's put up 22 tonight. Darius Jackson with some tough yards. Maybe even tough yard for the senior from Sparta, Illinois. who's the team leader in rushing for Eastern Michigan. Ninth in the nation in scoring and first in the MAC coming into tonight's game is Darius Jackson. No more trickeration. This is Cody Tuttle. He'll pull it down. The quarterback, Roback, trying to throw a block, but nobody's fooling Devon Gonchar, who stuck right with it.
I think Tuttle wanted to throw that ball down the field, but he thought better of it. You see the reverse coming. LSU did a nice job staying back. You can see he got some routes developing outside. Cody was saying, I don't think that's going to work.
So now third down and very long.
LSU opting to play base here, looking like they want to pressure.
Roll back to throw. Throws on the run. It's picked off. Going back the other way. Deion Jones with a pick six for LSU.
Deion Jones getting his opportunity. Been kind of a special teams demon for the Tigers in the past, showing good speed and anticipation. Roback's made some good decisions today. That was not one of them.
His second interception on the night and his sixth interception thrown this season. And the point after try by Trent Domang is good. So Deion Jones, they call him Debo, the senior from New Orleans. Leader in tackles for the team, gets the touchdown tonight. There is the score with still 12 and a half minutes to go in this fourth quarter after the interception return for a touchdown by Deion Jones has given LSU a sudden lead after it was just a one-score game, an eight-point lead not all that long ago. Rogan Roback throwing his second interception on the night. And so the Eagle offense will come back onto the field momentarily. Roback's numbers, 14 of 20, 119 yards, one touchdown pass, but two interceptions, one of which led directly to seven LSU points.
He's done a pretty nice job tonight, Allen. He really has. He's managed the game well, moved around the pocket. He's running a little bit.
You don't get many opportunities, you know, when you're playing a team that you're overmatched against, if you will. Your heart can carry you so far, but you can only get so many opportunities to overcome the stakes.
Got to be clean.
Shaq Van on the run, and let's check in with Brendan Fitzgerald.
Allen, we're going to check in on a top 10 team out west. UCLA is on the ropes at home against Arizona State. Mike Bercovici keeps it, goes up the gut 34 yards in the touchdown. Arizona State has added another one, and it's a 19-point Sun Devil lead.
All right, Brendan, thanks. So a 22-point gain here at Baton Rouge and Eastern Michigan. Out to start at their own 23-yard line. Van is the setback. Darius Jackson also there. Van will have the ball. Nope, it'll be thrown. Sam Browning with the reception from Roback. His knee will hit down at the 31-yard line. There is a penalty marker on the field. Holding territory.
Ineligible receiver downfield. Offense, number 71. 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Darian Terrell's raising his arms like, come on, man. You're not buying it. He like knew it was a naked bootleg.
So back him up. And it'll be back to the 18-yard line for Chris Creighton and Eastern Michigan. What's your takeaway from tonight's game?
He wasn't worried about the score coming in here, and I don't think he's still worried about the score. Of course, you want to win. But the response of his team has been phenomenal. You know, they've played with heart. They've overcome some adversity. They're playing together. They're hanging in there. Not quitting. All those things are great signs.
He says where his team is this year compared to last year. Said when he got to Eastern Michigan, basically he felt like the program was in turmoil and kind of downtrodden. And the pass over the middle. And a nice gain there to get back most everything and get close to first down yardage. Sam Browning on the reception.
Super throw. Under pressure, leaning back. Good strong arm. Watch him here. He's going to get pressure up inside. He's going to fade away, throw that thing coming back. That's a strong arm. It's an accurate arm. Good anticipation.
So from first and long to second and short now. Handoff. Jackson will move the chains for Eastern Michigan. So continuing on that theme about Chris Creighton and his team, said basically, you know, the program was kind of downtrodden. And he said his first year he had to kind of meet the program where it was and start to build it from there. Now he says these guys on this team look after each other like family. He feels a completely different atmosphere around the club. And while he says Saturdays can still be frustrating at times while they recruit and build the talent, the culture of the program is beginning to turn the corner.
You've got to set benchmarks and victories along the way that maybe aren't necessarily on the scoreboard. And whether that's in the weight room or the classroom, he talked about all that stuff is up. Their numbers in the weight room, the numbers in the classroom, looking at their participation, looking at their leadership. All those things are on the uptick.
And the second and five here. And the handoff again to Jackson. It was wrapped up and dropped down. Now the road ahead doesn't get any easier for Eastern Michigan after visiting LSU tonight. Of course, they play in that very competitive Western Division of the MAC. And look at those bottom three that they have coming up in October.
Yeah, on the road against the Rockets at Northern Illinois. And a Western Michigan squad that's much, much improved with P.J. Fleck. That is not easy, along with, oh, yeah, that one at the top, Death Valley.
So third and three. Van will have the first down and more hanging on to his shirt tails. Donnie Alexander kept him from getting away for a really big gain, but it's across midfield at a move of the chains.
It's been impressive because Eastern Michigan, when they've wanted to run the ball, they have run the ball.
Van, former All-State performer in track and field as a high school sophomore and junior. Second on the team in rushing. And he'll have the ball in his hands again after the inside throw. Let's check back again with Brendan.
Allen, Florida continues to put it on Ole Miss. Chad Kelly back to pass. He's going to get picked off by Vernon Hargraves right around midfield. This led to a field goal, and it is 31-3 Gators.
Wow.
Yeah, well, we had Chad Kelly last week, and we talked about him taking care of the football. He turned it over twice there, and getting these tough games, you got to manage that football.
And after the comeback win over Tennessee, Gators got a little something going in the swamp. Look at that, nice tap and catch there. And Sam Browning still running down inside the 10-yard line. A nice catch followed by a nice run for the Escondido, California tight end.
Roback standing back at the 50. Nicky's anticipating bad news.
It's a penalty flag sitting at the 15-yard line.
Holding offense number 80. The penalty is 10 yards. It's called a foul. After enforcement of the penalty yardage, it will still be a first down.
Austin Stone, the redshirt sophomore wide receiver.
That was a superb throw. Brogan Roback, man, he is showing some arm talent out here tonight. Doesn't always have a great base with his feet, but he turned and flicked that thing in the only place it could go. Don't take him out in a dart contest downtown, because this guy can flick it.
Gonna throw again. And another interception. Kevin Tolliver was the one that ball was headed right for.
I jinxed him. Kevin Tolliver, another freshman, early enrollee, playing man coverage, got his eyes on the ball, playing it the whole way.
That was something funny about that. Dustin Creel, the receiver, was looking around like he wasn't sure what route he was supposed to be running or something.
Yeah, I'm not sure if he thought maybe it should be a back shoulder throw.
First down.
So they will back LSU all the way up to the 2 yard line, and they'll take over first and 10 there. Darrell Williams is in the backfield. ...45 yards of rushing for the sophomore. And out of his own end zone. Hit right there. But surges forward after the contact. Now he's free! He was a step away from having a huge gain, and he just got tripped up. How did he come out of the pile in the first place?
That's the weight room. Big, strong legs, banging. They've been running this lead zone. Look at that. Boom!
Eastern Michigan's done a good job of tackling all night, but that one, not so much.
Loaded. They've been loading up the box. Again, another nine-man front.
Brandon Harris hands to Williams. He'll squirt through into the secondary, knocked down at the 20-yard line. So will we see Leonard Fournette again tonight? He's 17 yards away from equaling the single game rushing yardage record at LSU. Stands at 233, the record's at 250. We are in the fourth quarter, halfway through it, with a 22-point lead.
Coach Miles may keep him hungry, try to get that record down the road in an SEC game.
Another one for Williams. Won't get much coming near side. The road ahead for LSU, you talked about Kip Fournette. Maybe get that mark against one of these upcoming conference opponents. There are some of the numbers he's put up against those that LSU still has to face.
Some great backs in this league. But it's going to be some great matchups.
Darius Geis, the true freshman, comes in while Fournette stands on the sideline. May have seen the last of number 7 tonight. We'll see.
You're right. I think you're right.
Also a new fullback, Rakeithan Moton, true freshman that Cam Cameron said was very much like a Lorenzo Neal, leading the way as Geis powers forward and across the 30-yard line.
Darius Geis, 5'11", 222. Coming with that same lead zone play. They really like this guy.
He's from Baton Rouge. Can walk here to the campus from his home. Cam Cameron says he's going to be a great player. Emphasis.
And he's seen a few, so he knows.
Geis with the ball again. And a nifty move to the outside before he's trapped along the sideline and finally forced out of bounds at midfield.
Said, hey, I know number 7's good, but I got a little something, something too.
LSU certainly loaded with young talent on this team.
The other freshman is Nick Bassett, who's very talented as well. And Leonard's the old man as a sophomore.
Yeah. He's been around forever. Guy's still fighting for tough yards down to the 45. Nice. And you look at the offensive depth chart for LSU as Geis comes out of the game and Nick Brossette goes in. Offense and defense, you find a lot of young players in the two deep.
Well, one of the issues there is they get so many great players here. They're here for 3 years and gone.
Second and five, Harris handing off. Now Brossette will have the first down and bring the ball inside the 40 to the 38.
Really impressed by all these backs, how they take care of the football and really care for it. And it's a little thing, but you know it's emphasized. You just see the way they run with the ball positioning. They know how deadly turnovers can be.
And they have gotten it done on the ground tonight. The passing game very ineffective for LSU. Only 80 yards of passing tonight on 15 attempts, only 4 completions. It's all been on the ground. And continues to be. Not much on that carry on first down.
Yeah, he kind of squirted through at the end. Mark of a good back is always falling forward, pushing the pile. I think it's going to back it up a little bit.
So what do you make of what you've seen from LSU tonight and what you've seen? You know, we saw Ole Miss last week. You saw Alabama and the highs and lows they've had. What do you make of what you're seeing from Les Miles' team?
I think what Coach said yesterday when we met with him is true. Like, whoever gets hot kind of can avoid injury. You know the running game and their defense is going to keep them in games. They're going to have to obviously get the passing game going. You're not going to be able to run it every time when you get it, start getting some of these. You see Alabama, that'll be definitely one that's on. Florida starting to show up defensively as well. You just can't be one-dimensional in this league.
Texas A&M out in front of Mississippi State tonight. That one here in Baton Rouge at the end of the regular season. Basically what Les Miles said was he thought there were 6 to 12 teams in the country who could catch fire and do things that are special. That's the quote. He said, we're one of them. As Williams is back in the game. But they do have some things they have to work on if they're going to catch fire and be one of those special teams.
Yeah, and again, that's true of everybody. I think if you look around the country and we see some of the scores today and you say, oh my goodness, I never predicted that. Should that game be that close? And that's obviously why you play. Got Anthony Jennings coming into the game now, quarterback. Brandon Harris checking out.
So Jennings into the game, the junior from Marietta, Georgia, will end Brandon Harris's night.
Of course, Anthony was the starter last year.
Yep. And he'll hand off to Williams. He'll rumble forward. Is that he'll be across the line to gain, bring it down to the 15-yard line rather, and move the chains at a first down. There's a look at Anthony Jennings and the stats on him. 11 touchdowns against 7 interceptions a year ago, a little under 50% as a passer, 48.9%. They had a tough camp fight to see who the starting quarterback would be, but Brandon Harris won out in that fight. And here's Williams again, dragging people with him down toward the 5-yard line. And the clock runs at a minute and a half left to go in the ball game.
Going to be interesting when they go to the polls, huh?
Yeah.
And see what happens. And I think even more so when we get the committee, when they really dive into it, because they don't really care where the poll is. Right now, it's kind of like, you know, replacing a Tetris game.
Yeah.
but they may look at it and say, hey, the Buckeyes, not close to being number one team in the country.
A month away from the committee's first rankings revealing for the college football playoff. As Williams is stacked up, falls forward, and all the way down to the 2-yard line. And we're less than a minute to go in the game. First down, clock stops while they reset the chains. And we wind here with LSU driving and ahead by 22.
I think you got to feel solid. I think you got to keep Ohio State in there right now. They won it last year. I think Baylor is a team right now that's playing pretty great. pretty good football. Obviously, Alabama with a huge win. Now, they lost to Ole Miss, but also turned it over five times, which doesn't help you.
So victory formation here, a drive that started back on the two-yard line will end on the two-yard line. And Chris Creighton is going to call a timeout. What's going on here? Somebody signaled a timeout and the clock stopped. And now players are gathering at the center of the field. And whatever in the world just happened there will result in the clock running out, and LSU remaining undefeated at 4-0 with a 22-point win. Leonard Fournette, 233 yards rushing, 26 carries with three touchdowns. Far and away the offensive leader for this Tiger team. So LSU stays undefeated next week. A big game for them at South Carolina. And Fournette will continue to lead the Heisman Trophy favorite conversation as we go throughout the week based on tonight's performance. College Football Scoreboard is coming up next. For Dan Hawkins and our ESPNU College Football Primetime crew, Alan Bestwick saying goodnight from Baton Rouge, where LSU is a 44-22 winner.